Hello there! Today I'm going to take you to Budapest. So by the Ural Pass, we're going to take a train from Vienna to Budapest. It takes about 2 hours 30 minutes. This is Vienna Hauptbahnhof. As you see, there is so many restaurants, bakeries, and don't forget to try this. It's the best food ever. You can get this in the station. Okay, so as we book our room at Airbnb, we stay at the Vivian apartment. So she wrote to me how to get to her apartment. Get the Budapest telephone, and then we take the green metro line 4 until the crossing tier, line 3, and then we switch line into the blue metro line 3, and then after 4 stop, and we go into the direction of Gothic, get down at the Budapest station, and we walk about 10 minutes up first. So here we are, a beautiful apartment, very clean. You see the bed is so comfortable, the kitchen is so clean, and all the complete set for cooking, but we didn't cook here. So also you see the shower room. I'm very happy with the Vivian apartment, and Vivian also very nice. She told us how to get to the tourist point, as recommended on the Airbnb. It's full of sunshine here, so I love this apartment so much. Thank you, Vivian. After check-in and take a rest for a while, so we walk to the Budapest Parliament. It's only about 15 minutes walk. It's very easy. This is the Gothic Hungarian Parliament House, located in the city of Budapest, and only a few steps to the Danube River and also the chain bridge. Look at the Gothic design, it's so beautiful. Oh my god, this is amazing. Budapest was united from the three cities in the 1873, and 7 years later, the Diet resolved to establish a new representative parliament building, expressing the sovereignty of the nation. About 100,000 people were involved in the construction, during which the 40 million bricks, 500,000 precious stones, and 40 kilograms gold was used. Wow. Since World War II, the legislature became unicameral, and today the government uses only a small portion of the building. The Parliament building is in the Gothic Revival style. It has a symmetrical facade and a central dome. The dome is a Renaissance Revival architecture. What is
it? Okay, ini Budapest. Saya lagi ada di Parliament.
Too bad we cannot enter
House.
Because this is late.
Di sini sedang terjadi demo besar-besaran.
Well, actually there has been a week, according to the people here. There is a demonstration, And the unique thing is make the traffic very good example for other people like Indonesia. Hey guys, do not do the demonstration in the daytime. So we see there is so much police over here, and we are not feel scared at all. Now we are walking to the riverside to look at the view of the Danube River at the night time. All the lights are on. You see, this is amazing. I love this place so much. And over here, you see, it's overlooking to the Danube River, the King's Bridge, and also overlooking to the castle. So the King Bridge itself is in Budapest city from the Buda and Pest. It's because we only have one night here, and tomorrow we are going to Salzburg. So hopefully tomorrow morning we can wake up early and look the other side on the castle. But this morning is raining, so we cannot go out for sightseeing. But I have some recommendation for you if you want to go one day to Budapest. So here is all the visitors point for you to go. It was a YouTube clip. It is some video from the YouTuber I took. Maybe can assist you. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and share. Ciao!